individualism has become a dirty word. Like most things in the West are getting corrupted. Marriage is now defined as slavery, as monogamy, monotony, and education is producing terrible tyrants, or potentially, etc. So yes, everything good in the West came from the Bible, and as it was secularized, it was corrupted. The individualism came like St. Paul. He says in Galatians 6 that through the cross, I'm dead to the world. The world is dead to me. I don't try to please the world, because for me to live is Christ. This was God's call to Abraham, that you leave your father, your mother, your culture. You follow me, you walk with me, and then I will bless you. I will make you a great nation, because through you, I want to bless your nation, all the other nations that are walking in darkness. But an individual who conforms to the world can't change the world. The one who walks with God, he becomes different. Then he can change the world. So God says to Abraham, Abraham's wife has said, take my mistress, sleep with her. God says, no, you get rid of your mistresses and your children. You walk with me. Don't even listen to your wife when she's asking you to do something that is not my will. So that was individualism, which you came to Europe through St. Augustine's book, Confessions. So that was the first time in literature where you see an author taking responsibility for his life, being honest with him, and wanting God to change his life. And this book was written 1,000 years before printing existed, and it was hand copied and studied and meditated upon. And that is what bred in individualism in the West from the Bible. So it turned into Reformation. So when Martin Luther stands up for some truths, he says, my conscience is captive to the word of God. And it's not right, it's not safe to go against my conscience and conform to my church. My church is wrong. Church fathers are wrong. I will not recant unless you can persuade me from scriptures and from plain reason that I'm wrong. Then I will recant. I'm not stubborn. I'm being truthful to my conscience and obedient to God's voice. So this was the individualism, which you already before Luther, you see that in Columbus, you see that in Vasco da Gama. The West was producing individuals who were thinking differently. We don't have to go east in order to go to India, although we know that India is in the east. We can go through the West. We don't have to go through the Mediterranean. We can go through the Atlantic. So this individualism, which is pushing the envelope, as they say in English, to the limits of exploration. So the West was, in this biblical worldview, producing great individuals, which advances civilization in medicine, in science, in knowledge, in economics, in law, in government, etc., and reforms Europe. But in 1841, Ralph Waldo Emerson, a transcendentalist philosopher, essayist, he publishes an essay called Self-Reliance, in which he's saying, you be the master of your own life, your own destiny. Now, his models for selfishness, self-individualism, are Moses, Plato, Milton. But what he is doing is basically saying, don't even go to church. Seek solitude. Listen to your own inner voice, inner intuition, imagination. Pursue that. This is what it means to be human. So the difference between biblical individualism and secularized individualism is best illustrated by Jesus' prayer in the Garden of Gethsemane. Jesus has no martyr complex. He wants the cup of the cross to be taken away. But he prays, not my will, but thine be done. if you love the world enough, this is a world that hates you, that hates me, but you want to save this world using my blood, my body, I give myself to you. You break me. Let my blood flow for salvation of my enemies. So I'm not going to pray that these people who are crucifying me, they may be consumed by fire. I'm going to pray, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. So this was the biblical individualism, was an individual giving himself to God, a radical surrender to God, so that God could take my body, break it, shed my blood, save the world through me. This was the heroism and individualism of the missionary movement from the West. But what secularized individualism does is says that the universe exists for me. God exists for me. Jesus came for me. Heaven is for me. I'm the center of the universe. If this pregnancy is inconvenient, I'm going to kill my own baby. If this spouse, husband, or wife is not really fulfilling my needs and my interests, I'm going to divorce. So I don't make any sacrifices for the world. The world is sacrificed for me. That is what is destroying the West. And you are right that individualism has become a destructive world. But that is because the West has become post-Christian. It's no longer guided. The words such as individualism, heroism, family, these are not guided by the Bible, God's wisdom. They have defined whatever I want them to mean, they mean. So that is true.